There's only one God, and that's the God of the scriptures.
Amen.
Read what it say now.
Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
Wait. What did the Bible say?
Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
Wait. Hold it. I know the Bible didn't say that because I just prayed to God last night. The Bible said what?
Now we know that God heareth not.
Now we know that God
heareth not.
Heareth not.
Sinners.
You know what heareth not mean?
Mm-hmm.
We ain't that slow. My sister used to say all the time, she said, I'm slow, but I ain't that slow. We know that God heareth not sinners, but read what the Bible says.
But if any man be a worshiper of God. And doeth his will.
And not only a worshiper, but do his will.
Him he heareth.
Understand that?
Mm-hmm.
That's clear, ain't it?
Amen.
We don't even need no revelation for that, do we?
Amen.
Only prayer God should hear from a sinner is one who's repentant. Other than that, what are you praying about? Oh God, I need you to work this out for me in my life. I need you to move this mountain in my life. No, he does that for the saints.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Don't think you're going to live any kind of way and still receive his privileges. Versus one who's suffering to come out the flesh,
amen.
Resisting to come out sin, striving to follow the commandments of God, even to the point of crying sometimes because they're striving and fighting to be right. And then you mean to tell me you're going to come along, ain't trying to serve no God, don't have a mind to be right, don't have a mind to do right, and you think you're going to have the same privilege to talk to my God?
Mm-hmm.
And not only talk to my God, because you can talk to him, but then he's going to hear you.
Amen.
That's not fair.
That's right.
Jesus said, my Father is no respecter person. And how is it that you think you can live any kind of way, walk any kind of way, talk any kind of way, and here's one sister, one brother striving to obey the will of God and do what God said according to his word? And you mean to tell me you're going to have the same privilege as me to pray and God hear you? Read what it said again now, because people don't believe what the Bible says. Don't say I said it. Folks will look at me, oh, he's so judgmental. You better shut up. Mm-hmm. I'm not judgmental. I'm just reading what the Bible says and quoting what it says. Read what the Bible says.
31. Now we know that God heareth not sinners.
So now, you gonna call me judgmental, you might as well call the Bible judgmental too. Because I'm just repeating what it said. Watch.
Heareth not sinners.
Heareth not sinners.
But if any man be a worshiper of God.
A worshiper of God. Now, how did God say worship him? Thank you. You can need Bible for that. That's in the same book of John.
Amen.
It said that God is calling for true worshipers. Such to worship him in spirit and in truth. Being the worship of God don't mean singing Kirk Franklin all day.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, I was just worshiping God. I was just worship. You weren't doing nothing but singing. That's not worship. Singing Kirk, he'll never put more on me than I can be.
Amen.
My son, get that scripture for me. I believe that's in John. Get that for me. If any man be a worshiper, get that for me. Worship is spiritual. Get that for me now, because you know, People don't believe what this Bible say. I told you, most of these churches need to just close down. We're wasting time. And I know what one sister said. Oh, he's so judged. Yeah, whatever. Most of these churches need to close down. I blame my friend of the people on the preachers. Because they ain't telling the people what the Bible say.
Amen.
You either in true worship or you're not. Mother, so get that from the book, chapter, and verse. Let the audience hear it. St. John 4:23. 4:23. Let's see what the Bible says. You say you are a worshiper. Let's find out. A one, a two. Y'all remember that commercial?
Yes.
A three. Three.
Amen.
Let's find out if you are a true worshiper.
Amen. St. John 4:23.
What does it say?
But the hour cometh. And now is.
And now is.
When the true.
Get the verse above that.
Amen. 21. Jesus saith unto her. Woman.
Believe me.
The hour cometh.
The hour cometh.
When you shall neither in this mountain.
Nor yet at Jerusalem.
Worship the Father. Ye worship, ye know not what.
That's what's going on right now. People are worshiping, don't even know what they worship.
Mm-hmm.
You, in your songs, they say God, but you don't know him.
Mm-hmm.
Read that part again.
Ye worship, ye know not what.
You don't know what you're singing to. You don't even know who you're singing to. Because you never met him.
Amen.
You can't tell about their relationship with God. I can tell you what this Bible say. You never met him. And he never met you. What? Yes, I can give you Bible for that. Jesus said, didn't you cast out devils in my name? And in my name did many great. He gonna say, depart from me. I never knew you. So if he don't know them who've been casting out demons and doing mighty works, what makes you think he know you and all you've been doing is singing gospel songs all your life? He don't know you. He don't know the one that's been casting out devils, doing mighty works and mighty acts. He said, I never knew you. So what makes you think he knows you? And all you've been doing is praying every now and then and singing gospel music. Come on, man, we gotta wake up.
Amen.
Come on, read what the Bible say now.
You work.
Stuff is hard, but it's right anyway.
Amen.
Amen. If you was to put, if Jesus came in this world today, he wouldn't know what these preachers talked about.
Amen.
He wouldn't know. He'll walk up in the churches. What is they talking about?
Amen.
What is they talking? I never said that.
Amen.
It ain't about the outside. It's about the heart. It ain't about that because you never seen a true saint.
Amen.
So you don't know how one should look.
Amen.
Jesus came in these churches today. Or the apostles came in these churches today. They'd be like, my God, what is this? This is the synagogue of Satan.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
I'm about to tell the truth anyway.
Amen.
It ain't about the outside. It's about the inside. But don't you think eventually from the inside it's going to manifest on the outside what you got on the inside?
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, read what he say now. I know people getting mad.
22, ye worship.
You worship?
Ye know not what.
That you don't know what?
We know what.
But we. See, I know what we worship.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the preacher's so strong and don't care what people got to say about
it. Amen.
Because I know who I worship.
Amen.
I know how you're supposed to worship. If any man be a true worshiper of God, glory to God. See, I'm a true worshiper. I know how you're supposed to look, how you're supposed to carry yourself. I know the speech that's supposed to come out of your mouth. Even when you talk about this God that I serve, I should be able to say, amen. Read what the Bible says.
We know what we worship.
You ain't the only one, right? I never said that, but I know.
Amen. Amen.
We know what we worship, read.
For salvation.
For salvation.
is of the Jews.
Is of the Jews.
But the hour coming.
But the hour coming.
And now is.
And now is.
When the true worshipers.
When the true what?
Worshipers.
If there to be a true worshiper, that means it has to be a false worshiper.
Amen. Yeah. Right.
When,
that's right. That's
when,
right.
That's it. So is that talking about people who do voodoo?
Yeah.
No. Is that, you know why? That's not the, it's talking about those who label themselves as worshipers of God. So that means these are people who are worshiping God or think they are worshiping God, but they are not.
Amen.
For there to be a true, there has to be a false. Or else he would not have said true. He would have just said worshipers. But he said true.
When the true worshipers.
When the true worshipers read.
Shall worship the Father.
Shall worship the Father how?
In spirit.
Wait a minute, how?
In spirit.
Whoa. In spirit. You know what that means? You can't even be a worshiper if you don't have the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
The apostle said, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? Why did he say that? You may be a believer. Like these brothers, I was getting my things done, and these brothers, they were sitting up in the office, and I'm listening to them. They're playing the gospel music, and I'm listening to the gospel music, and they had the thing say, prayer is free, and I'm looking, I'm like, oh, okay. I say, so what the faith are you gentlemen in? They say, we just believers. He asked me, he said, are you a believer? I said, yes, sir, yes, sir. But I wanted to get in some dialogue. I want to know, what is it that you believe? Because you got to be more than just a believer. Because listen, Peter asked him, he said, have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? You know what that tells me? You can be a believer and still don't have God's Spirit.
Amen.
And if you don't have God's Spirit, the Bible say you're not his.
That's right.
I don't care how much you believe. Yes, I'm a believer. That don't mean nothing.
Amen.
Have you received the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Since you believe, they say we never even heard of a Holy Ghost. Glory to God. But guess what? They believe so much. So they believe the words of the apostle. And the Bible say, they say, well, what baptism were you baptized with? They said the baptism of John. My God, listen, Peter began to baptize them, brother. They got baptized in the name of Jesus Christ and filled with the Holy Ghost. Now, it's not enough just to say you're a believer because you can be a believer and don't have his spirit. That's not enough. You got to go past just being a believer.
Amen.
You got to do something after you believe. Or I believe in God. So, what? You want to cook? That ain't enough.
Amen.
Amen. Many people believe education is paramount. Anybody going to college?
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
Hello, somebody. But we believe in education.
Amen.
But guess what? Do it do me some good just saying I believe in education?
No.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm still not reaping the benefits. Amen.
Amen.
But I ain't going to school. Amen.
Amen.
But I believe in education.
Amen.
What good is it talking about you believe in God? You ain't going to reap the benefits.
Amen.
Until you go further than that. You got to get in the race.
Amen.
Amen. It says worshipers that's going to worship me in spirit. I'm almost finished.
Amen. And in truth.
So you got to have the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Now watch this. It says, and in truth. What is truth? Give me St. John 16:16 or St. John 17:17. This one. Let's see how you're supposed to worship him. It says in spirit and in truth. Let's see how you're supposed to worship him. Yeah, which one is that? St. John 17:17?
Amen.
Give me St. John 17:17.
Amen.
What did he say?
Sanctify them.
Sanctify them.
Through thy truth.
Through thy truth.
Thy word.
Thy word.
Is true.
How are you worshiping? You don't even know his word.
Amen.
You know what that shows you? That us in here are not 100% worshipers. We're learning how to be worshipers.
Amen.
Now how you in the world, you a full-fledged worshiper of God. Shut your mouth. We just striving to be worshipers. Because we're doing what Jesus said. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. You ain't even learning about it. But you talking about you're a worshiper? And we over here learning to be worshipers?
Amen.
We learning how to be worshipers.
Uh-huh.
We don't even have it down pat, because every day we learning how to get closer to God.
That's right.
And as we learn, we're striving to put on and striving the things that he said take off, to take on.
That's right.
And you got the boldness to say out of your own mouth that we are worshipers of God? Liars.
Amen.
Read what the Bible says.
Sanctify them through thy truth.
Sanctify them through thy truth.
Thy word is truth. Thy word.
Thy what?
Thy word.
Thy what?
Thy word is truth.
That means after the word comes, you ought to shut your mouth.
Amen.
You may disagree with what I'm saying, but when this word comes, you ought to shut up.
Amen.
Because the word is right, and it takes precedence over all.
That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah to God. That's the same thing with me. I can be talking because I believe a certain way. But if you bring that word to me, you know what I got to do? I got to shut up. Because the word is right.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, let's go back to the true worship. Let's go back. I'm almost finished. I'm almost finished. But I have to certify all of this talking that I'm doing. People say I got a big mouth, but I'm able to back it up.
Amen.
Do nothing to meet me on Facebook because they know they can't stand up against it.
Amen.
I'm a hot mess. I'll be a mess. I am a mess. I'm a mess in this Bible. I come stirring up the pot everywhere I go. I stir up the pot. Amen. I'm not gonna make up no God for you to receive. I'm gonna say, here, this is God. You gotta eat it just like this.
Amen.
All wrong. You gotta chew it. It ain't right. Just don't taste right. Chew it! You say you want this God. I'm not gonna fix him up all pretty for you. So you, no. What do you think this is?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
I was talking to a bishop, and I had to ask him because I was just so flabbergasted. I said, what's going on, Bishop? I'm seeing now, you know, you got women preaching in your pulpit now, and I see you got women with all this makeup on their face. They look crazy. What's going on? I mean, you didn't used to be like this. What? I said, well, maybe I missed something. Can you help me? He said, it's all about God. And you got to be able, people are hurting. And you got to be able to minister to the hurt. Listen, I agree. But what good is it? It's dealing with all their hurt and then they're still sinners. They are healed sinners. You ain't preaching no salvation to them.
Amen.
Listen, in that case, every psychiatrist should be called church. I've got to be honest with you.
Amen.
Yes, you're supposed to come for healing and for restoration, but also the saving of your soul.
Amen.
And so after I minister to talking about all that hurt and, you know, abuse, and okay, I understand that. Trust, I understand that. But then after that, it's like, okay, now, let's go to this Bible. Now you got to conform to this Bible now.
Uh-huh.
You ain't going to talk about just going away just healed. And, no, that's not just the purpose of the church. It's to save your soul from hell.
Amen.
You don't believe me, I got my Bible for it. There were 10 that came to Jesus. He healed them of their disease. Listen, 9 of them left. Only one came back to say thank you.
Amen.
Only one.
Mm-hmm.
You know what that showed you? Everybody's not in this for the saving of their soul. They just want something from God.
Amen.
But then guess what? God wants something from you too.
Amen. Yes, sir.
You go away healed, but then what? You still going to hell. If you ain't repented, yeah, he healed you, but you ain't received no salvation. Chapel, you right. I agree with all of that. He said, well, you preach what you preach, and I'm going to preach what I preach. I say, no.
No.
No, no, no. You don't have a different Bible than what I have.
That's right.
It's the same Bible.
Amen.
And the apostle said, I have not failed to declare to you the whole counsel of God.
Amen.
So if you can't go through this Bible and preach everything that's in it, you're a false prophet.
That's right.
God gave me that. Many times people go to the Bible and say, you know what, I'm not going to preach that. Start going to look at it and say certain things they're not going to preach. you just became a false prophet because now you're picking and choosing what to give the people and what not to give them.
Amen.
Paul say, I have given the whole counsel. What is the whole counsel?
Oh.
All of it. All of it. That means no matter what's in here, preacher, preacher.
Yes, sir.
I don't care what's in here. I don't care if you got a second husband, I'm preaching. I don't care if you got a fourth wife, I'm preaching. You hear me?
Amen.
I don't care if you're a woman that call yourself a bishop. If that's what my eyes fell on to preach, I'm going to preach it. I don't care who it touched. Listen, I believe it so much until it even touched me.
Amen.
I'm preaching.
Amen.
Other than that, you're a false prophet. Oh, I ain't going to preach that because that kind of hit me a little bit. No, I ain't going to preach that yet. That's I'm found guilty in that, so no, I ain't going to preach that. You're a false prophet. You're a lying false prophet. And you're going to hell with the devil.
Amen.
Read what the Bible said. I'm almost finished.
Amen. Back to St. John 4:23. But the hour cometh, and
now is,
when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh to
worship him.
God is a spirit. Amen.
God is a what?
God is a spirit, and they that worship him must.
You can.
Must.
You should.
Must.
Must. Ain't no other way.
Must worship him in spirit,
spirit
and in truth.
He said must.
Must.
Amen.
Must. You know what that means? You gotta do it.
That's right.
That's why sometimes I talk slick to the people. I say you better do it. You better do it. You gotta do it. You don't have to hear me, but you better do it. You don't even have to like me, but you better. You better. He's so better. Yeah, you better. Because when you open his Bible, it's going to say the same thing to you. He's going to tell you, you must.
Amen.
Oh, God. I'm almost finished, church. I'm almost finished. You know, I can do this all day, but I know we got to go. I ain't know. Let's go back. Let's just finish out what we was.
Deuteronomy?
Yeah, let's just go back. And then I believe it's Deuteronomy 32. Let's just go back so we can close it on up.
Amen.
Close it on up. Finish reading it out.
Deuteronomy 32:20.
I tell you, everybody who ain't never been baptized, don't talk about God, you're going to hell. this is crazy. Y'all know they look like I'm crazy. But it's the truth. If you haven't, listen, if you haven't been baptized in Jesus' name, you're going to hell. Ain't no Bible for that. Yeah, you're going to hell. God gives a word. Why do you think he's going to sit here and give us a word and then you can choose it whether you want to do it or not? Come on, y'all.
Amen.
One young preacher came to me. He said, when I told him, I said, no, you ain't baptized, brother. I said, you ain't got it like the Bible said. He said, I'm reminded of the thief on the cross. You can remind all you want. He said, I'm reminded of the thief on the cross that the thief wasn't baptized, but Jesus said to the thief, this day, you're going to be with me in paradise. And he wasn't baptized. Is that true?
No.
That is true. But have you ever wondered why Jesus, all the time that he was on the earth, Listen, let me just certify this and that's it. I'm finished. I promise you. I'm supposed to get me St. John chapter 3 and verse 1. Because you know people like to run to that thief on the cross talking about, well, the thief on the cross wasn't baptized. But Jesus said, this day you're going to be with me in paradise. He said, I'm reminded. Let's see what the Bible says. Now,
people
that say,
St. John 3:1.
Yeah, verse 1.
Amen. St. John 3:1.
Yeah,
there was a man of the Pharisees, named Nicodemus,
a
ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night.
They
said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher.
Come from God.
For no man can do these miracles.
That
thou doest, except God be with him.
Yes.
Jesus answered and said unto him,
Verily,
I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.
He said, you won't even be able to see. Right?
Amen.
Keep reading.
Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born?
Jesus answered,
Verily,
I say unto thee,
except a man be born of water.
Wait. How do you gotta be born?
Of water.
How do you gotta be born?
Of water.
And what?
And of the Spirit.
And of the Spirit, what?
He cannot enter into the kingdom of God.
Is that Bible?
It's Bible.
You got to be baptized and you got to have the Spirit. Now, the preacher said, I'm reminded. He got what he told me. He said, I'm reminded of the thief on the cross. Now, watch this. I want to show y'all something. Give me Luke. Chapter 23, verse 39. And we finish. Luke 23. Let's look at the thief on the cross.
39?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
39, what does it say?
It says, and one of the malefactors.
One of the malefactors, which is one of the thieves on the cross.
Which was hanged railed on him.
Saying,
If thou be Christ,
save thyself and us. And save us, Jesus.
But the other answering rebuked the other thief. Saying, Does not thou fear God?
Do you not fear God?
Seeing thou art in the same condemnation. And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds.
But this man hath done nothing amiss. Yes.
And he said unto Jesus,
Lord,
remember me when thou comest.
That's what he talked about. He said, Lord, remember me when thou comest
into thy kingdom.
Yes.
And Jesus said unto him,
Verily, I say unto thee,
today
shalt thou be
with me in paradise.
Hold. So that means that day, that man went to heaven, didn't he?
He's in paradise.
Jesus said, that day, this day, you're going to be with me.
No. Today.
Yeah, today.
Today.
Today you won't be with me.
Amen.
But now the question is, when Jesus died, did he go straight to heaven?
Nope.
What you mean he did?
Mm-mm.
He went in the grave.
Really? So what was Jesus talking about this day? You won't be with me in paradise.
Oh,
and I said, y'all got to help me because that's a contradiction of the Bible.
Amen.
Why didn't Jesus tell a man, all this time Jesus came preaching, why didn't he talk about, he was talking about the kingdom of heaven. And this man said, Lord, remember me when thou art in our kingdom. Jesus said, this day you're going to be with me in paradise. You know what Jesus was telling that man? He was telling him this day, yeah, you're going to die. You're going to be with me in the grave. What? He was talking about the grave.
Amen.
Well, then let's think about Lazarus and the rich man. The rich man, where did he go?
Hell.
He went to hell. Where did Lazarus go?
Abraham.
Oh, so you mean to tell me he didn't go to heaven? Where did he go?
He went to rest.
So he was in a place of what?
Rest.
Rest.
He rested in the bosom of Abraham.
Rest. So when Jesus told the rich, he didn't tell that thief that you're going to be with me in heaven because this day, because Jesus didn't go to heaven that day. He went down in the grave, hell, which was the grave, not the place of torment, because he was talking about the one that he had to preach to that never heard the gospel. They were in the grave. That's why David said, thou shalt not leave my soul in hell. Meaning you ain't going to leave my soul in the grave. Jesus knew what he was saying. That man had not been baptized. Jesus could not go back on his word. And that's why when he talked to the man, he didn't tell the man, "You this day you're going to be with me in heaven," because that day he did not go to heaven. He went 3 days preaching in the grave to those that never heard the gospel. That's what he was telling the rich, that thief, where he was going. What did St. John 3:3 say? Because that would make St. John 3:3 alive. What did he say now?
St. John 3:3.
Mm-hmm. See how these people don't know no Bible? I'm reminded of the thief. Well, if it's this day, that made Jesus lie because Jesus didn't go to heaven that day. Uh-huh. He went 3 days preaching. He didn't go back up until way after the time of Matthew 28:19. And that was 40-something days. The Bible says he was seen in different places. Seen of the apostles, the disciples in different places. Ate bread with others here. Went walking through the wall over here. He had not yet went up yet. But yet Jesus told the man, "This day you're going to be with me."
Amen.
He didn't say in the kingdom. He said in paradise.
Amen.
Meaning, yeah, today you're going to die.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you're going to be in a state of rest. That's what he was talking about. Because that would make St. John 3:3 alive.
Mm-hmm.
Read what St. John 3:3 say.
Jesus answered and said unto him, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God."
And read the next verse.
Nicodemus said unto him, "How can a man be born when he is old?"
I'm almost finished, y'all. I know I talk too much. Come on.
"Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born?"
What did Jesus say?
Jesus answered, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit."
Will a man be born of water? No.